The U.S. military has detonated a 20-ton bomb next to the new Gerald R Ford aircraft supercarrier. The explosion was so powerful that it registered 3.9 on the Richter scale. The blast is comparable to 100 modern depth charges exploding simultaneously. The test was what the U.S. Navy calls a full ship shock trial, and warships are not considered ready for combat without successfully facing one. The U.S. Navy was keen to point out that the precautions that have been taken to ensure the test complies with environmental mitigation requirements, respecting known migration patterns of marine life in the test area. This is the first of the three blasts. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the U.S. Navy has exploded a 20-ton bomb near the USS Gerald R. Ford supercarrier. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play online military-themed strategy game, Conflict of Nations, which is played by millions of players worldwide. We talk a lot about military power and tactical plans of different nations on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? Conflict of Nations is set in the late 20th and early 21st century, fielding present-day and highly modern battlefield technology. At the core of the game is an exciting real-time combat system, placing players in control of an existing nation of this world and its army, pitting them against other gamers in a struggle for world domination. Units are moved across the map in real time, often taking hours to fulfill their assigned mission goals, allowing for a very deep level of strategic planning and integrated tactical execution. Forming lasting alliances or short-lived coalitions is an essential part of the modern military environment. Hence, Conflict of Nations allows players to form cooperative clans and teams in an all-out effort to conquer set objectives through the combined force of arms. Conflict of Nations can be played in PC or mobile. So why wait? Register yourself using the link in the description below and get 13,000 gold reward along with 1 month Security Council membership. Nimitz-class carriers have been the face of the U.S. Navy and have enabled power projection far off from the U.S. homeland. USS Nimitz, the lead ship of the Nimitz-class, was commissioned in 1975. The Nimitz-class has been able to accommodate many new technologies over the decades, but the Nimitz design has now reached its threshold, and this is where Ford-class comes in. Ford-class supercarriers are being built to replace some of the United States Navy's existing Nimitz-class carriers. The first ship of this class is USS Gerald R. Ford. It's the costliest single military asset in the world. The ships of this class are expected to be in service with the U.S. Navy till 2065. The carriers have been envisaged to be more efficient and future-proof. The new vessels have a hull and displacement similar to the Nimitz class, but introduce many new technologies. Full ship shock trials, FSSTS, include large blasts designed to mimic real-world scenarios. The U.S. Navy's shock trial event is the first of its kind on any class of ship since 2016, aims to prove the new carrier can withstand a hit in combat. As reported in Defense News, Lieutenant Commander Desiree Frame, a Ford spokeswoman, stated the ship will go through two more scheduled blasts in June and July. She said, "In a shock trial, a ship undergoes three 40,000-pound explosive charge detonations, which occur successively closer to the ship. The exact dates for each blast are dependent on sea state, weather, marine mammal activity, and several other factors." Frame added, prior to the blast, the U.S. Navy planned the event using advanced computer modeling methods, testing, and analysis to ensure the ship is hardened to withstand battle conditions. And these shock trials provide data used in validating the shock hardness of the ship. Viewers may note that the entire ship is specifically prepared for the trials with thousands of miles of cabling to support external test equipment and sensors. The last time trials like this were carried out on an American supercarrier was 34 years ago with the USS Theodore Roosevelt, CVN-71. American Ford-class supercarrier is one of the most complex pieces of engineering in the world. There are many upgrades when compared to the Nimitz-class supercarrier, which is itself an engineering marvel. For example, Nimitz-class supercarriers got planes moving for takeoff using steam-actuated catapults, whereas Ford-class uses electromagnetic aircraft launch system, EMALS, which uses a linear induction motor with an electric current to generate a magnetic field that propels a carriage down a track. The two Bechtel A-1B nuclear reactors installed on USS Gerald R Ford are capable of producing 300 megawatts of electricity, triple the 100 megawatts of each Nimitz-class vessel. The huge power supply provides for the legroom required for future expansions, like inducting lasers and electromagnetic railguns. Also, Ford-class uses extensive automation to make the ship operate more efficiently. Battle shocks are realities, and bottom line is that a naval asset, especially a supercarrier, needs to be able to take a nearby explosion and continue to fight. It's important that all components of the warship continue to function even if a major explosion occurs close to the warship. A blast could occur from anti-ship missiles, naval mines, torpedoes, or even other ships nearby that get hit by enemy weaponry. FSSTS include validation of almost everything, including the hardiness of onboard computer systems to nuclear reactor elements. American supercarriers are the face of the U.S. Navy and have allowed power projection far away from the homeland. The U.S. is the only nation to operate so many supercarriers since they're very costly to build and operate. Due to technical and economic constraints, there are currently only a few countries with aircraft carriers, let alone having so many of these nuclear-powered mammoth supercarriers. Rivals know they can't match American supercarriers in quality and quantity, hence they're trying to develop asymmetric weapons to counter them. This includes weapons specifically designed to take out American supercarriers, like the Chinese DF-21D anti-ship ballistic missile, touted as carrier killer. In this situation, it's paramount the Ford-class supercarriers are as robust as possible. FSSTS can unearth vulnerabilities that need to be reinforced in USS Gerald R. Ford. This will also be equally useful for other vessels of this class, four of which are planned and three of which are under assembly currently.